My name is Lanre Da Silva Ajayi. I'm a fashion designer, self-named Lanre Da Silva Ajayi. My journey actually started from the Victorian era. I remember when I started then and how Nigeria was, people were not sure if it was going to be that much accepted. But I would like to say that Nigerian women are very fashionable. We love fashion in Nigeria, in Africa, and that has really helped. The feedbacks have been very, very positive over the years. And that has really, really like also given me a positive, you know, when your collection is being well embraced and received, it also helps for you to do more and keep doing more. And now I'm here 15 years. What makes my craft special to me is simply being very passionate about the fashion industry. The passion drives my creativity to be innovative. I love when I'm in my quiet zone. I go into libraries, when I travel, TV. Almost everything around me actually inspires my collection. So I think for me, it's almost anything from books, you know. Obviously, I love to sketch. And then I love colors, you know, fabrication, all of those things being put together, depending on what collection I'm working on at the particular time, the season that I'm working with also helps. And I would say that the main thing is actually the passion, like I said earlier on. And, you know, creativity is something that is really, really important when it comes to fashion, you know. So I think those are things that are special to me, like, you know, going through almost everything around me, from just even watching an old movie. My brand has definitely evolved over the years of the industry because I started in 2005. So it's been 15 years as of I speak now. It's evolved over time. I actually modify for today's woman. When I started, I used a lot of fabrics, Victorian era trimmings, accessories, and it was really like high neck outfits, and then people would actually ask themselves if they would love, if Nigerians would accept, and if Africans are ready for this. And I think what also helped me was that the uniqueness and being different was also a very key part of my success, because at the time people were not wearing stuff like that. And so people found it very different. And I think sometimes when it's different, then it has this risk involved around it. And then people are interested and want to try it out. So it started like that. The first year, people started getting to understand my collection. And you could almost spot a line that's over Ajayi when you see one. And I think that was something that was very, very unique to myself. And by the second, third year, I found that people were beginning to love it. Obviously, I've done a lot of shows with Arise. I don't know if you remember the London Royal Albert Hall. And that collection was amazing, was very different from what everybody had seen. And then from then, people started, and it's interesting to know that I started seeing the use of Chantilly laces, the Victorian era kind of, you know, headpieces, a lot of accessories, trimmings, fabrication, jacquard, damask, what's this fabric now that, you know, you could hardly see the Victorian lace, you know, very goupil. Goupil was something I used a lot in my early years. And over time, I moved into a bit of silks, a bit of softness came into it. You know, because for me, it's always almost the same thing. It's almost the same, you know, recycling. Fashion is all about recycling. It's never really different. But you just do it seasonally and make it, twist it up a bit, modify it a bit for women to love to wear. And I think of my target market. So for me, I think I make clothes for every woman. So I think of, you know, what would a woman love to wear? Different fabrics. So I think of daytime, lunch, evening wear, cocktail. So it really depends on what I'm looking at. But in most of my collection, I would say over the years, I do a lot of, I do shorts, I do long dresses, I do evening wears. I do almost everything I want to think about and just change it around a bit. But as of today, sometimes I look back at some of my collection and play around it and still put it back, but in a different way. Make I tell you waiting up for a bullet. Body's big party inside by a bullet. I went there with my best friend Kule. Kule they there with in girlfriend Shile. Ghetto girls then they like Takasufi. So many pretty girls they inside my mule. I just the one that say which can party, yeah. Everything yakba, everything day. Ah, we
bougie. I get many guests with them, they come from away. AJ boys and they like to throw it. Almost he go be. We just having fun. We won't carry on. Crazy guests like make the stallion. But my girlfriend, they yeah, they turn me on. That's why I hold on tight. Hold on, yeah, yeah. Hold on tight. Hold on, yeah, yeah. That's why I hold on tight. Hold on, yeah, yeah. Hold on tight. Hold on, yeah, yeah.
Wow, my top three looks and my influences for the collection I just showcased now, I would say, is actually putting together from my previous collections. So what we had done was we looked through what I've done over the years and tried to put it into a story. There were some green looks, my classic looks, where some bold dresses they need. The use of, I remember that I collaborated with Ayo, an artist. So there was that in the collection. There's a beautiful story, sequins, use of sequin fabrics, use of organza. I love organza. I remember that I also had some of my jackets, you know, the boy jacket, evening wear. There was a Victorian, I think that was the finale, a Victorian big dress. So those are things, it was almost a story about how I've come from the time I started till now. So it was an inclusion of my classic looks and basically saying the story around the LDA brand. Nigeria is 60, and I feel like we've come a very long way. We've grown a lot as a people. I think the fashion industry can only get better because I can only say it's very lucrative. It's booming. There's a lot of interest. Everyone's looking into Africa. Our prints are seen all over the world. Our Ankara prints, which were things that before you could not even wear to big occasions. Now I see people wear it and wear it very confidently. I can only see Africa going to the next level. You know, there'll be bigger stores, there'll be a lot because we're contributing a lot to the economy, to the turnover. A lot of young people want to be in fashion. They love fashion. They're confident. They feel comfortable. So the next 6 years can only be much, much better than right now. So very thankful to God for where we are. I'm very thankful to God for my brand. And I can only pray that Nigeria will be better and better and better, by God's grace. Amen. I would love to wish Nigeria Happy Independence Day. It's exciting to be a Nigerian. I'm excited. I'm an entrepreneur. My name is Larry Da Silva Jai. I'm Nigerian. I love Nigeria, and we can only get better. And I know I would like to say things could seem a bit tough, but there is always that promise, a land of opportunity. Nigeria is a beautiful place for you to. I started my business here as an entrepreneur, and I've grown into what I am today. So I can only say that thank you to Nigerians everywhere around the world, and love you, Nigeria.